Hi to everyone. In this lecture, I am just going to discuss about how to represent the numbers using heap. Okay, so you just see here. Here the list of numbers is given here. Okay, actually it's given in terms of sequential representations. At first, we have to convert it into the heap. Okay, how can we draw it here? Means first node you can write it here 97, and then the next two possibilities are 88 and then 95. Okay, and then you can write 66, then you can write 55. Okay, then you can have the two possible nodes. What are they? You can have it as 95 and 98. But notice one thing, if you are making use of the max heap for your representations, before inserting 98, all are same. There is no problem. It satisfies all the conditions, because 95 is greater than or equal to the value which is present in its parent node. Okay, but while inserting 98, you are having the problem, right? What's the problem coming here? 98 is greater than 95. So what I'm just going to do it here means I'm just going to swap these two numbers. Okay, so 95 which will come here and 98 which will appear here. Okay, even after swapping this one, again the condition is not at all satisfied for the max heap. Okay, so what I'm just going to do it, 98 is greater than 97, that's why I'm just going to swap these two numbers. So 98 which will appear here and 97 which will appear here. Okay, and then so after doing these things, the next one number is 36. I can insert it here. Okay, so in this way only you can represent the list of elements in the heap. It can be of a max heap or else it can be of a min heap. Here I have represented it by using the max heap. If it is of a min heap, the least, the minimum number should present in the parent node. Okay, that means the value which is present in the parent node must be less than or equal to the values which is present in its child nodes. Okay, so that's all about the representations of heap. In the next video we will discuss about as how to insert an element into the heap. Okay, thank you.